How to read construction drawings. In this video, I'm going to give you a sketch about the approach. I'm not going to take you through individual plan sets and details, but I'm going to give you an approach that I think you're going to love. And if you're like, hey, but I want somebody to take me to the plan and show me, I'm going to link you to one of the coolest series on how to read drawings that I have found in construction. So if you're into that in this video, please stay with us. I just want to be clear with everybody. The video that I did about this 2 years ago was well received, but I did get some comments that hurt my feelings. A couple of comments were like, Jason keeps talking, but he's not showing me anything. That's on purpose. So to save me my hurt feelings and your time, if you're literally looking for an actual example, go down to the description below and just skip my talking and go straight to that. But I do feel like this is a much more important topic for me to talk about because there's hundreds of videos on the specifics, but very few videos about the approach. And so that's what I'm going to talk to you about right now. Let me just go ahead and talk about some of the key aspects here. Let's just assume that you're getting your paper from Sustainable Forests and that you've printed out your drawings. And literally, you're sitting there and you're looking at them, and literally it's 8, 12, 14, maybe 24 inches tall on your desk. And you're like, what am I going to do? Let's say you're building a mega project. Literally, I want to give you this image. You need to carve out, let's just say 4 hours when you first start, especially if you're in a position like field director or general superintendent, project super PM, and you literally need to go and you still have your stack, and that's super fine, your stack of drawings, but you get one drawing set, okay? And you literally flip the drawings and you just mark a couple key, this is so good, how could somebody make fun of me in the comments for this. You're gonna be looking at a couple of different things. Constraints. You're gonna be looking at on the drawings and marking, you know, is there anything constraining me? Is there an adjacent building? Is it required to wait 7 days for waterproofing after we strip the wall forms? Like, we're looking at different things that are constraining us, okay? The other thing that we're looking at is the overall flow or the sequence. And yes, this is for PMs or superintendents. This might seem superintendent heavy, but this is for both. What that means is when you're looking at the drawings, even though it's not final at this point, but can you start to mark how you think the project is going to flow? Then the third thing is you're going to start to break the project down. So, you know, what are your functional areas on the site? What are your phases? What are the zones within it? So I'm just gonna do functional areas, phases, zones, right? Because what you'll wanna do is start to organize the project that way. If it's a lot of drawings in a massive project or super complex, this is going to be your first approach. You're not gonna go too in depth. I do wanna share that recently on a project, it was only 96 million, but I was still like, ooh, it's pretty complex. I did this, and as an outgrowth of this, I was able to see where the team should focus, what the priorities were, what the risks were, what we needed to look at from a procurement standpoint. And so basically, all the things that I needed to do early on, I was able to do because I looked at the drawings from a high level. Then I found myself, okay, all of this stuff is in line, and now I need to go through drawing set, one by one, to create the scopes for the bid packages, and I need to start doing a detailed constructability review. So that's super fine. I absolutely love that. Here's what I want to communicate. When we're reading drawings, you're going to have a couple of different sets that you're looking at. So you'll have your structural, this is supposed to be isometric, man. Architectural, you'll have mechanical, electrical, plumbing, right? And you'll have IT, you'll have all these different drawings, landscaping, civil, right? Now, when you're approaching this, if it's a commercial project, you will probably early on spend most of your time here and here. So that is an approach, right? I could take you over to the details right now, but I want to give you the approach. Then you start working into mechanical, electrical, plumbing, low voltage, right? And you start researching there. You'll want to hit the flow diagrams or the one line diagrams early on here, but getting into the details for these will come later. If you are in the industrial world, you may want to start out here and then spend time in these other areas last, because industrial is very heavy mechanical, electrical, plumbing, fire protection, IT, it's very systems heavy, okay? And what I'm trying to communicate here is that when you're reading drawings, you'll take this general approach and then you'll follow, and I'll link you to this video below. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna link you to the video that we have on this channel about how to actually read the drawings, and then I'm gonna give you detailed instruction through another video series for how you actually look at the different symbols. But I wanna give you the general framework right now. When you read a set of drawings, you wanna go to the general notes first. I know it's boring, go there first. Highlight anything that's pertinent. Then you're going to go to the typical details, okay? And I want you to spend some time there. Then you're going to go to the abbreviations and symbols, okay? And what that's going to do, you have now learned the language of the drawings. So not only do you have the right approach for when to dive in, but now you know what sets to dive into first. And when you do it, you'll have this discipline. General notes, typical details, abbreviations, and symbols. You have just learned a new language. Like if you're going to learn Korean, for example, you are going to learn how they structure their language, the symbols, how they speak, verbs, conjugation, nouns, the whole thing. Like you're going to learn the language. And then what you do from there is you go into each page and you understand, and this is key, you understand all the symbols and what things mean, especially on the electrical mechanical drawings. Plumbing's typically pretty self-explanatory, but mechanical, electrical, and IT. You need to understand the symbols, and if you didn't already pick it up from here, you need to ask your foreman or professional. Once you know that, then start tracing details to understand what's going on in the project. And then once you've got a couple of pages down, you'll be like, I've got it. Now, the entire electrical set is within your grasp. The entire mechanical set is within your grasp. The entire structural set is within your grasp. There's no need in the comments to say, Jason keeps talking with no examples. It's in the description below. Follow this approach. Hit the right level of detail or you'll get overwhelmed. Do first things first or else you'll get overwhelmed. Get into a pattern and a discipline or else you'll get overwhelmed. But if you follow this step, you'll become a master tool belt, and you'll be able to knock this out of the park and read any set of drawings at the right time. And then you go in and you make it a habit every day, 15, 30 minutes, every builder, read the drawings, study the drawings, 15 to 30 minutes every morning about work that's about to happen and complex areas, so that when you walk and you look at your production plan, you know what's coming up. You can build it from the drawings. This is the main skill of a builder. And so I'm going to give you this in the form of a blog post, and feel free to reach out to me anytime the right way. You hurt my feelings. I hope you've enjoyed this video. On we go.